During the 1982 World Cup finals in Spain, Trevor Francis was a member of an English team which performed well enough to secure a hard-earned quarter-final.
World Cup, Diego Maradona virtually did it single-handed for Argentina. And then we come to 1988, when Marco van Basten was absolutely superb for Holland. And I think that he was one of the main reasons, along with Pullet and Rijkaard, why Holland were successful. And I think in England's case, in 1988, they were surprisingly beaten by Ireland. I don't think anyone expected that, despite the fact that Ireland under Jack Charlton were doing quite well at the time. And then, of course, you know, we lost to the Holland side, who were the best side in Europe at that time, and they went on to prove that by winning in the final against Russia. And by the time that we faced Russia, we were so deflated, and we knew that we were on our way back to England, that the game was of little significance. I think that, you know, okay, it was a very disappointing time for us, but, you know, we did lose, you know, to sides who were very, very good sides.
In the 1988 European Championship, 8 teams have progressed from 32 entrants. Germany, a side that included such dominant names as Klinsmann, Matthäus and Hassler, were the host nation, and although favourites to win the tournament, got off to a wretched start. Holland were there with 4 key men in place: Ruud Gullit, Frank Rijkaard, Marco van Basten and coach Rinus Michels, who had been drafted back into the Dutch fold after a long spell of acrimonious absence.
Ik ben 87, eind 87, begin...
The reason for this is a typically 88. Dutch story. For an outsider, hardly understandable. But okay.
Ik wilde dus bij het Nederlands...
At the end of 1978, I handed in my notice. I wanted to leave my position as technical director of the national team.
Wilde ik dus weg.
This had to do with the fact that at my employers, the Board of Professional Football, there was a man who would rather see us lose than win. This may sound strange, but it is true. I won't go into details now about why, but this was the case.
Rijkaard was played in defense.
Was een ideale middenvelder.
Rijkaard was an ideal midfield player. If I had had an alternative in the defense, with 2 men covering, as we call it, we like to play with 2 men covering and a free man, then I most certainly would not have taken Rijkaard out of the midfield. But I was short of a second covering man of ability who would also have a capacity in the air. That is why I asked Rijkaard, in the interest of the team, if he was prepared to play in that role. Looking at our way of playing, he didn't have to limit himself to just covering, as long as this was compensated for by someone else. Then he could also participate in building up an attack. Moreover, it fitted in with our way of playing. That was the fact of it. He accepted this. Everybody had a lot to say about the decision. But the way Rijkaard is, if he says I'll do it, then he will do it. But at the same time, he is a Dutchman. Let's not forget that. He is the kind of guy who will tell you if he doesn't want to do something. If he does it, then he will do it well. That's the way Rijkaard was. So it was not just a matter of being better as a midfield player. He could do both.
Maar hij is zo'n jongen. Als hij het niet wil, dan zegt hij het ook. En als hij het doet, dan doet hij het goed. En dat was dus Rijkaard.
Except for a World Cup winner's medal, Frank Rijkaard won every international honor and every club honor in all the national leagues in which he'd played.
Ik was zeker blij omdat ik...
Indeed, I was happy about this because I went to the European Championship in 1988 after I'd been non-active for a long time. I had left Ajax in the middle of the season and had not played football for 6 to 7 months. So I was happy that I could join the selection to go to Germany. Then it was a case of getting a place. This place appeared to be a position in the defense, and I was extremely happy that I could simply join the Dutch team in the European Championship after quite a disappointing season.
Having lost their opening fixture against the USSR, the Dutch were then pitted against the English.
Dat was voor ons alles of niets.
That was make or break for us.
In mijn ogen goed spelen tegen Rusland, verloren we nogal ongelukkig met een soort van counter en uitbraak. In een koop van Rats, meen ik. En toen was de wedstrijd voor, tegen Engeland al voor ons erop of voor ons.
I think we were lucky, because England played a very good game. And they could have won.
Gehad, want Engeland speelde een zeer goede
wedstrijd. And deserved to win. But luck was on our side as a team, and there were good individual performances, such as Marco van Basten, who scored 3 times and who was in top physical condition.
Van Basten's startling control, grace and uncanny accuracy brought the Dutch relief, their first goal of the finals. However, in typical fashion, the English stirred themselves and came up with a strike full of courage and willful determination. One goal each. After the interval, Michels was on his feet when Van Basten added his second, and the Dutch could afford to feel just a little more confident. A hat-trick for Van Basten, the only true difference between the two teams on the day, and Holland had gained valuable points. The English would lose to the USSR, who headed the group, while the Dutch were left to face a stern challenge from Ireland for the right to progress into the semi-finals.
The
Irish were so difficult to play against because they applied a tremendous pressure football technique. Pressure on the ball, the football space, and on an opponent.
Pressure football hadden op de bal, in de ruimte en op de tegenstander.
They had demonstrated this in their 2 previous matches. The pressure was the reason for their success. The strange thing was that because they only needed to draw with us, they didn't dare do it the way they had previously. And in fact, this became their downfall.
Op de manier dat ze het voor die tijd gedaan hebben. En in wijze is dat ook een ondergang geweest. Want ze gaven ons.
They gave us more opportunities to play football. And consequently, we were a little better than the Irish were.
The Irish defended their lines like a fighter refusing to yield canvas. They, after all, only needed a draw to go forward into a fantasy semi-final against the host favourites, West Germany. Then Michels played the most astute substitution of his career.
Kieft was dus als pinch-hitter, hij wist dat ook, hij wist dus dat hij alleen maar erin
kwam. Kieft was the substitute.
Dus
he knew he would only have a chance of playing if the match wasn't going as it should for us.
Dat hij dus de laatste half uur man was.
He was the last half hour man if we needed him.
Toen gedwongen had en ik heb hem toen ook.
I told him at the time, I hope you don't have to come on.
Maar hij kwam dus
zelfs spelen. Been called upon to play lots of times.
En
so it was logical to bring him on because the game remained at 0-0. And we had to score. He was the substitute, and he came on to score an incredible goal. Luck only comes to you if you try everything you can. That includes having the courage to take a chance. Sometimes luck is on your side, although you cannot rely on it. And you cannot complain if it doesn't work out. I still believe that we deserved it more than the Irish because they played a too withheld game and let us attack too much. There is always the danger that something like this will happen. And it happened.
Semi-final. West Germany against Holland.
Andere wedstrijd. Dan normaal. Bovendien, het is een halve finale in een eindtoernooi.
Tensions are high anyway in the semifinals, the last match before the final.
Het was een revanche.
It was seen as our retaliation match for the final in 1974.
Opgebouwd nogmaals weer.
This notion was created by outsiders, especially the media.
Door de media. Daar zat nogal een brok koude oorlog omheen.
There was quite a war element involved, which the Germans were especially good at.
Vooral sterk in zijn. Thank you.
Thank you.